Aloha everyone, my name is Charles, and this is the Hawaii Volcano Watch Report for January 6, 2020. Based on the USGS report, the west vent was spattering from the top of a small cone on the crater's northwest wall. As well, lava continues to flow down the narrow channel into the lake, creating the mesmerizing dome fountain eruption. Based on measurements taken on Tuesday, January 5th, the lava lake was 192 meters or 630 feet deep and had an approximate volume of 27 million cubic meters. Using the thermal map from the 5th, the USGS has calculated that the perched lake dimensions are 760 by 520 meters or 2,490 by 1,710 feet with a surface area of around 70 acres. That makes it somewhat smaller than the measurements from December 30, 2020. However, the perched edges of the lake were about 1 to 2 meters above the narrow ledge. You can visualize this perched edge as like the walls of an above-ground swimming pool. The solidified lava island floating in the lake is proceeding to rotate counterclockwise in front of the west lava vent. However, the 11 smaller lava islands moved around just a bit, but have remained in the lake's east end. Looking at the large lava island, it appears the dimensions have remained relatively the same. It was measured as around 250 meters long by 135 meters wide, or 820 feet long by 440 feet wide, with an area of about 7 acres. Height measurements show the island surface was around 6 meters or 20 feet above the lake surface on January 1st, though on January 4th, that measurement increased to about 7.8 meters or 23 to 26 feet. Gas emission rates at the summit, measured on January 3rd, were in the range of 3,000 to 6,500 tons per day. This range has been approximately the same since December 27th, and is comparable to the pre-2018 lava lake measurements. If we look at the deformation data, we can see summit tilt meters registering deflationary tilt since January 1st, 2021. Though, seismic activity remained elevated but stable, which includes elevated tremors and minor earthquakes. Moving on to the Upper East Rift Zone, located between the summit and Pu'u'o'o, monitoring instruments indicated the area contracted while the summit deflated when the eruption began. Monitoring devices have detected no seismic or deformation data to signify any additional magma moving into either of Kilauea's east or south rift zones. For now, it would appear this eruption will remain upon the summit of the Kilauea volcano. To continue receiving updates on the current Kilauea eruption, click that subscribe button, then the bell icon, and select all notifications. Also, be sure to show that like button some aloha as well. Mahalo for watching, and have an incredible morning, afternoon, or evening.